Time travel is one of those things that varies from franchise to franchise. Everyone has different rules. Star Trek, Avengers, Back to the Future. This is something to keep in mind as we build out our site for Hayes Valley. And it applies here because we're going to put up a screenshot. And this screenshot's special. That's because this screenshot is from the future. Do we have a time machine? Yes, but that's not what we're using here. Instead, Creamer's using the magic of video editing. And throughout this part of the course, we're going to put up before and after screenshots so you can see what we're going to build in the future. With that in mind, let's jump in and cover five things. We'll do the main structure of the hero section, which is a grid. We'll place an image of their design work. We'll make a block for the other content, like the heading and the buttons. We'll tweak our layout and build an overlapping grid. And finally, we'll make some adjustments to the body all pages tag. This will let us prepare the rest of the site so we have to do less work as we move on. Okay, first part. What we want to do is drag in a grid. And the grid's going to serve as our primary structure. This is for the home hero section. And from here, we could add columns, we could remove columns, we could do the same with rows, but 2x2 is fine. That's basically our structure. So let's hit done and name it. Now, when we started making changes, it automatically created a class called grid. Let's double click to edit, and we'll call this home hero section. And we can take care of some dimensions. Now, dimensions by default on things like this are determined by the content inside the grid. So if we started placing content right now, that can help us size. But for this, let's use a height. Let's actually define the height as 100 VH. VH, of course, meaning viewport height. So if our browser gets shorter, the viewport, that grid, is going to match the height of the viewport. That's the basic grid. Let's move on to the image. Now, the image is going to be placed inside the grid. And there are a few ways to do this, but for flexibility, we'll use a div block, just dragging the div block right into the hero section. And let's give that a name so we can keep things organized. We'll call it home hero image. And let's set a background image on this element. Go in here, choose image, and since we dragged in our assets before, all we have to do is choose the one we want. Now, it's tiled. There are a ton of them. We can fix that real quick by switching to cover. That means the image will cover the div block and position it from the center. So if we resize it, for instance, if we span this content across two columns, the center point will always remain in the center. Same if we span it across two rows. Let's put it back to the top left for now. And that's our image. Let's move on to the content. Now, for the content, we're going to use another div block. Again, we'll keep this organized. So when we drag it in, we'll add a class. We'll call it home hero content. And to figure out what we're putting inside that div block, let's consult our notes. And we can see there's a heading, an H1. We have a subheading, and then we have two different buttons. So let's place those inside our div block. And to make things a little easier to navigate and place, we'll open up our navigator. And let's go to add our heading. Now, rather than drag this around our grid, let's drag it in the navigator to home hero content. That way we can ensure it's placed right inside that div block. We'll let go. And by default, it's an H1. That's what we want. Let's double click to edit. We can select it and type, we make homes look beautiful. To keep things organized, again, let's create a class before we style anything. Let's call it major heading. You can call yours whatever you'd like. And once we do, let's make some changes to styling. Change our font to Playfair Display. Select the correct weight from the dropdown, and we can affect the color as well. So from color, we can grab the eyedropper tool and pick something that's closer to one of the colors in the image here. And let's warm it up a little bit using our selection here. We can always change that later. Let's add it as a swatch, and by doing that, we can come back to the color at some point later. Let's save, and that looks okay for now. Let's continue on to our paragraph. We'll go to the add panel, grab a paragraph, drop it into the home hero content right under the heading, and that's good for now. Let's drop in both buttons. Drag in a button. We can do that right inside the div block here, and we'll call this button Let's Chat. Go and add a class. We'll call it Button. And a few things we can do here. We can actually go to color and make it the same color as the heading. So we're really starting to get consistent with our colors here. And we can make some adjustments to the heading itself. Some margin at the bottom will increase spacing outside of that margin. Now, since we added a class already, since we added a class of button, we can simply copy and paste that element. Now we have two buttons, and we can change the text on the second one. see our work. Now, if we make changes on this class, for instance, if we add some margin, some extra space outside of the element to the right side, it'll affect both elements at once. And that's because each of these two elements has the button class applied. But that's our primary content we want inside of our Home Hero section. Let's work on layout, and we're going to create an overlapping grid. First things first, let's take our Home Hero content and place it on the bottom right. But if we try and drag it, if we just click and drag, we'll see, since it's automatically placed, since its position is set to auto up here, that means it's taking up the first available cell inside the grid. So we have this Home Hero image, which is taking up the first cell. The second next available cell is this one. So how do we override that? We can just switch our position to manual. Now, we can place it anywhere we want. We want it on the bottom right. And let's do the same thing on the Home Hero image. Let's change its position to manual, because we're going to do a change here by grabbing the corner and spanning it not just across two different columns, but across two different rows. Finally, let's make a change to Home Hero content in which we set a background color of something like white. In fact, we can choose from the default right here. Now, for sizing, let's edit our grid. This is the parent element, so let's select Home Hero section, and we can hit enter to edit our grid, or just click this little edit grid button. Now, when we edit a grid, we can affect things like the number of columns, the number of rows, the sizing of the columns, the sizing of the rows, and that's really what we want to get at. We want to control the sizing of these rows, the height. The height is set to auto right now, but if we click either of them, we could use something like fraction units. If we set the bottom one to 1FR, then we set the top one, just clicking here on the label, to 1FR, each of them are set up to 1FR. By setting the top to 1FR, by setting the bottom to 1FR, we've basically set it to 50-50, flexible fraction units. But what if we kept the top at 1FR, but set the bottom back to auto? The top row is taking up all the available space, and the bottom row is automatically sized based on the content inside. So let's make some adjustments to that content. First off, the heading, our major heading, by default has a top margin of 20. We can click that and just zero it out. And take a look at the bottom margin, it has 10. We could make that something like 20, space it out a little more. Same thing on our paragraph. We can take that default value of 10 and make it something like 20, maybe 40, or something in between. We can make it 30. And we can control spacing inside of these elements too. For instance, if we grab our div block, our Home Hero content div block, we can adjust padding. That's the space inside of an element. So we can do this on the top, we can do this on the bottom, or we can just hold down shift and adjust all four sides at once, landing on whatever value we think looks right. Let's do 30. And that's almost it for our Homepage Hero section. There is one consideration, and that's that the font for both the paragraph and the buttons is Arial. Now, since we're using classes on these, we could simply go in and change the font to whatever font we'd like to change it to, but there's a trick here, and that leads us from layout to the body all pages tag. Now, the body element is the top level element of any page, and because of that, we can go in and affect the body all pages tag. What that means is if we make a change to something like font on the body all pages tag, it'll affect the default font for any other element that's in the page, or any page. So let's go down and change Arial to Source Sans Pro, and we can change the font size default to something like 16 or 15. And the height, by default it's in pixels, but we can use unitless, so 1.4, just put a hyphen there, hit enter, that's unitless. Unitless is great because it scales with the font size. So if we change 15 to 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, you can see the height, the line height there, scales accordingly. So let's leave that at 15, and automatically the paragraph, the button, because we didn't set any overrides to the text on these elements, they're inheriting that font from the body all pages tag. But that's it. We added our grid, our image, the content block, we did our grid overlap, and we set some defaults on our body all pages tag. Before, blank page. After, hero section. Now, up next, we'll build out some more really impactful parts of our homepage. Then we'll take everything we did and make sure it's responsive on all different kinds of devices.